misty room. The lamp was softly dim to tell the stories of forgotten gloom. To read the signs we knew so well, we looked across receding tide, and nothing but the room had changed. The waterfall was by our side. The chairs had all been rearranged. And while we watched the things we knew, an old man came and touched my cheek. He told us he could stay a week and then move on to drink the dew. Fragment of the dawn was mine. I stretched across to take the key and caught it as it fell in time to save it from the failing sea. The locket fitted sure enough. Turn it now, I tried to hold. The door was made of stern stuff. The handle slipped, the windows barred. While we watched the things we knew, an old man came and touched my shoe. Sadly, what to do? And then moved on to drink the dew. We stumbled on into the night and touched each other lovingly, convinced that what we did was right, to hold our breath so knowingly. The time was on our side, we thought, though nothing else could be replaced. The sacrament of what we'd bought was quite enough to be betrayed. While we watched the things we knew, an old man came and touched my knee and told us gladly what to see, and then moved on to drink the dew. As the shrunken dawn returned, the curtains picked up shreds of light. The oil lamp empty faintly burned to pledge the truth about the night. The carpet still was on the floor, and in my hand the key was found. There before my feet the door, I opened it without a sound. While we watched the things we knew, an old man came and touched my head. He told us now it's time for bed. And another sight. He looked at me and shook his head. Then suddenly, with fresh delight, "Perhaps I've seen him too," he said. "Yes, I remember him," he cried. "He walks the narrow cobble stair, lifting up his voice with pride. He looks to see that no one's there. While we watched things we knew, an old man came and watched us too. He touches me and he touches you, and then moves on to drink the juice.